Track 51. While Witold and Maria arrived to Venice, Italy, they heard on city loudspeakers a speech of Mussolini, who just returned back from a meeting with Hitler in Berlin in September 1937. The fate of Polish peasants. Visiting Warsaw Symphony. Hitler annexing Czechoslovakia. Witold's French.
Il serait aussi intéressant d'ajouter que nous avons vu alors les préparatifs pour un accueil solennel de Mussolini revenant le lendemain de Berlin où il avait rendu visite à Hitler. Sur ces entrefaites, la foule s'était attroupée sur la célèbre place de Venise où dans un palais résidait Mussolini.
In translation. It is also of interest to add that while in Venice we have seen preparations for a solemn welcome being prepared for Mussolini returning the next morning from Berlin, where he has visited Hitler. To this effect, a crowd gathered on the famous Venice Square, where was located Mussolini's residence.
Par les haut-parleurs, les harangues prononcées par Hitler et Mussolini à Berlin.
And we were listening via city loudspeakers speeches of Mussolini and Hitler pronounced in Berlin. Mussolini speaking.
Wir Nationalsozialisten und Faschisten wollen den Frieden und werden immer bereit sein für den Frieden zu arbeiten, einen wirklichen, fruchtbaren Frieden, der die Fragen, die sich auf Zusammenleben der Völker ergeben, nicht mit Stillschweigen übergeht.
In translation. We National Socialists and Fascists declare we want a true, meaningful peace.
Donder die Lust. Der ganzen Welt sieht man fragt, was das Ergebnis der Begegnung von Berlin sein wird. Krieg oder Friede können wir antworten.
In translation. To our meeting in Berlin, we together with Hitler are declaring to the entire world, in between war and peace, we choose peace.
Der Führer und ich mit lauter Stimme, Friede!
Thank you.
The 18th of December 1938, we were in Warsaw attending a concert at the Symphony Hall where made its first appearance with his choir a famous German conductor Abendroth. At this unforgotten evening, we have heard masterpieces of Beethoven, the overture to Egmont and the Ninth Symphony. I may add that seats in the orchestra level were almost empty. In contrary, in the balcony tiers were packed with Jews, being by nature very passionate about music. The 17th of September 1938, I have noted in my diary, we live in very agitated times. We are living under a danger of an outbreak of a world war. At this moment is happening a conflict between Germany of Hitler and Czechoslovakia. At any moment are awaited first shots.